It was 3 weeks ago when workers removed the hands from the south face of the Bromo Seltzer clock. Today, they were reinstalled. While the clock hands on the other sides have been working properly since 1911, it was the south face clock that ran into problems and stopped working back in 2007.
We tried to do some internal fixings at first to get it fixed, but then we figured out that wasn't working, and then we had to raise some money and find some grants to cover the cost, because it does cost about $30,000 for us to do this.
Okay, ready, set, go.
This morning, after 3 weeks of milling and restoration work, the hands were ready to go back up, which you can imagine is not a simple job.
Not quite what we expected, but nothing ever is.
People on Utah Street seemed very interested in the whole process.
Pretty impressive, actually, I must say.
Really interesting, with it being built in 1911, I believe, right? Yeah, pretty impressive.
I think it's a great moment in Baltimore, a great part of history.
Around 10:15, after some pushing and shoving, the hour hand was back on the clock. Joe Wall, the facility director, is excited. The clock will be keeping correct time again.
It is an exciting day. It's great to have the clock coming back online after 3 years of being only three quarters functional. So I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be great to have all four faces working on the skyline again.
It will take a little time to synchronize all four sides of the clock. And by tomorrow, the Bromo Seltzer clock should be keeping perfect time on all four sides.
It's just a mechanical piece, so it's really just a matter of taking it apart, figuring out how to put it back together. And they're pretty simple, but there's a lot to do to get them restored, that's for sure.
Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV 11 News.